Building a lovely lake. Amazing job, I love it. Anyway, yeah, the 130 here. We got the dozers up there. And last night, literally end of the day, she dumped her water and the overheating alarm came off. So, first of all, we're gonna do some fixing here. Now there is two hoses underneath there, somewhere underneath there. Two hoses goes to the heater matrix behind the cab, and water was coming out underneath the floor mat and then dripping off here down there to the floor. So I got a feeling one of those two pipes that are behind the boom underneath. Anyway, it's easier to get underneath it from the bottom. So I'm gonna start it up quickly. It's cooled down now, it won't overheat for 1 minute. Start it up and turn it around so I can get underneath and then take the belly plate off and we'll see what's up. Early morning, first thing, get dirty. Let's see what's up here. There's a rubber thing. Where's that come from? I've got a water dripping here. It's going from there. Just a 3 to 5. So the actual water is coming above there. There's a 2 water pipe goes into the heater matrix. So I can't see from here. So I think the best thing to do is take the seat out and look at the heater matrix. Alright. So on the left, see water. From the heater box, and that heater box, that corner there, so the lake is in the heater matrix somewhere, and you can see that pump here. I'm not gonna take that out. I think I have to double check it, but if I'm right, we can bypass the heater matrix, just blank, or not blank, but just reconnect the two holes, the in and the return one, further down. Out of the cab, just reconnect them together, and this way we bypass the heater matrix, and that should work for now. Loving it.
His club got a workshop for that yard he's in.
Alright.
He's got a workshop for that yard.
Yeah. There we go.
What fair size you get?
Yeah, it's a big barn, yeah.
Oh, right.
You can get more than one machine. Yeah.
Oh, cool. What job for you then? All right, let's fill her up. I don't put the belly plate back up until we actually see what's up. Mm. I'm filthy and wet. Have you got any water left? Alright, a bypass there.
Heater matrix.
There you go. It's greased up as well. Yeah. That's gonna be our bridge down the foot, but I'm gonna show you.
This way, innit?
Looking all right, Nick? Fit through on that.
Anyway, I tidied up the footpath there this morning. It's all done, nice and tidy. Water can run off of it. And I just cut this footpath all the way around the pond. And there's a little shelving here. That's for vegetation to grow on the edges. And anyway, so I go around nicely. And I got a laser on that digger. I don't know if you can see it.
There it's beam flashing, if you can see it on the dipper. So I can see the level.
And on the far side there, from there to this all the way around to that tree there, it's good. But from here down to there is about 5-6 inch low, that's the right word, it's low, a little bit low. So I think tomorrow we got a D6 in the box up here, so gonna get there. And with the digger I can load the scraper from the hole, we can make it deeper, it's no problem, and then just empty on the top of the dam, put another 6-7 inch on it, and that would be it. It won't take long really. Alright, that's it for today. It's nice and tracked in, nice and tidy, so it should be alright. If you wonder what's the topsoil part made of the point, that's for vegetation, for lilies to grow, so it's gonna stay there. That's a lovely job, I love it. Nice, very nice looking thing. Radio, we'll see you later.